Hi, I'm Michael Burton with michaelburtonfilms.org, located in Salt Lake City, Utah. We're here talking about using Microsoft Windows. Now I want to explain to you how to set up a home network, or basically to go through the wizard setup on your computer. Let me start out by saying that Windows XP is a registered trademark of Microsoft, and I am in no way affiliated with Microsoft. To set up a home network on your computer, you go through a few easy steps. There's basically a network wizard that you follow that will walk you through the steps. This is important because, like for example, I have a router and I also have a modem, and I have to be able to set up my computer and tell my computer exactly what I have on my network. Come down to the start menu. You're going to want to go ahead and pull up your control panel. This will give you a few options here. Obviously, we're going to want to scroll up to where it says network and internet connections. Now, if we come here, it gives us a few options. Set up or change your internet connection. That's not what we want to do. Create a connection to the network at your workplace. We don't want to do that. Set up or change your home or small office network. This is the one we want to deal with. We want to set up our home or small office network. Now, I already have my office network set up, but this won't hurt running the wizard again. This is the network setup wizard. Just follow the instructions. It's very simple. Go ahead and click on the next button. This says, before you continue, review the checklist for creating a network. You must install the network cards, modems, and cables, turn on all computers, printers, and external modems, and connect to the internet. Currently, we have everything set up, so let's click next and move on. The next step is where you're selecting your connection method, how your computer connects to the internet. Right now, I have mine currently set on this computer connects to the internet through residential gateway or through another computer on my network. You can either select this one, especially because I run through a router, so I can either select this one or under other. I can also click other and then click next, and it gives me the option, this top one right here, where it says this computer connects to the internet directly or through a network hub. My hub would be my router and my modem. But I'm going to go ahead and reselect the computer selects to the residential gateway. So this is where you choose how your computer connects to the internet. This is my computer description and my computer name. I just call it office as my office computer. That way on my network, this computer, since I have multiple computers running off of one network, I can tell which computer I'm getting onto when I log onto one of my computers to pull files off. So go ahead, once you name your computer, give it a description, click next. This is now gonna be the name of your network. Right now my work group name is MS Home, but my network is GOMS family. Go ahead and click next after you name your work group name. That's so that if you go into your work group folder, you'll be able to kind of the same thing. It'll show which computers are in your work group. This turns on and off your file printer sharing, which is very important to me. This allows you to be able to print from any, if you have one printer hooked up to one computer and you have multiple computers on your network, you can print from one computer still to that printer through the other computer. And so the computer that we're currently on is my hub. So I turned on the file and printer sharing because I print from my other computers directly through this computer. So go ahead and click next. Now this gives you a little rundown on your setups here before you click next. Basically it tells you your computer description, your computer name, your work group name, tells you that the file printer sharing is turned on. And then what you want to do is apply the settings like it says here. You click next. If you wait for a second, as you can see, it's applying the settings. Now it says we're almost done. Asks us what we want to do. Do we want to create a network setup disk? Use the network setup disk I already have. Use my Windows XP CD or just finish the wizard. I don't need to run the wizard on other computers. I'm going to click just finish the wizard because I don't need to run it on other computers because it's already set up. Then it says to complete the network setup, basically, it says that you should set up your shared documents folder and your sharing files or folders. Everything's pretty much already set up for me. I'm just going to go ahead and click finish. And there you go. My home or small office network is set up. All of my other computers, my router should recognize my computer now on my network.